Hello and welcome back to the Hardway Learn channel. We're going to be working on the Kubota L6060 today again. We've got a couple different projects running right now, and to start with, we're going to be working on ballasting the rear tires. But before we actually start on the tires, we're going to jack this tractor up.
Just in case you found yourself watching a video about ballasting tires and didn't already know this, tractor tires are often filled with liquid to give the rear end more weight to counterbalance heavy implements that go on the front, like a front end loader. You can also use steel wheel weights, which are by comparison very expensive.
We're going to make a drill pump mount. The idea here is if I set this thing all up and I just let this spin, the drill's going to spin the pump around and torque the hoses, and it's going to be a mess. So what we need to happen is we need the drill not to move relative to the pump. And I think we're gonna try some zip ties, quick and dirty, and see if that'll work. Got some old leader hoses just laying around here that we'll use to attach to this pump. Maybe. That's so old, it's not going to come off of there. I'll have to cut that off. Newer hose would be more flexible. I think these have been laying around since Kim's grandfather passed away, and a lot of his garden stuff just came home with us. So these are probably as old as I am, I had to guess. But they will still serve a purpose here, so long as they are flexible enough to get onto this pump. Kim's grandfather had a rain catchment system for his garden that fed off of his house's gutters that wasn't that different than this. He had a drill motor to power the irrigation. Hoses. I've seen that set up more than once. We'll see if that's serviceable here in a second. I don't know if it's... I might put another zip tie around this just to keep it from torquing. I think that's reasonable. Just make a big loop and hitch it around both sides here. To attach to the hose and the tire, we have this adapter. It's an air-water adapter kit. It's got a bleeder valve on it, as it's supposed to. Let's see here. It's got some different size attachments that I keep dropping.
Seems like the right size.
Yeah, direct fit, so these adapters weren't needed. I did unscrew the whole valve stem, or the valve from the stem here. The nice thing about these valve stems on these Kubotas is they're in two pieces. I think it's specifically for making it easy to fill with liquid. Nice tight fit on there. You got that bleeder valve button right there to let the air out. I cleaned and sanitized this brute sort of Rubbermaid garbage can. It's got some water in it. Not a big deal. I believe this says it's a 44 gallon. So it's going to take more than this full to fill that tire to the top of the rim, which is what we want. This will give us a reservoir to put our liquid into. About the best deal going I've been able to find for a liquid that will do this is at Tractor Supply. It's this Traveler brand, just Tractor Supply's brand, RV and multi-purpose antifreeze. This is ethanol based. So it's primarily ethanol, water, and a denaturant and a dye. All right, so don't drink this. It's not gonna go well.
Made for RV water systems.
I know I'm gonna get comments from people that I should be using straight beet juice and there's nothing else. And I priced beet juice for these locally installed here, and it was something like $1,300, including the labor. Which, if I could get the beet juice delivered here without being a dealer, it shouldn't be nearly that expensive. It should actually be cheaper than this product. These were $2 and change, like $2.60 a gallon, where installed the beet juice was something like $13 or $14 a gallon. So a little bit of time and we should be in good shape.
Here we have the actual amount of time it takes to burn up a dry drill pump. Don't do this. You're actually going to need to prime the leader hose and prime it all the way through the pump every time you stop and start, because air pressure from your tire will actually push the liquid back all the way through into your reservoir.
Dry. All right, let's tear it down and figure out this pump. When the pump feels warm to the touch after that little bit of running, and watch this. The pump ate itself. There's chunks of plastic coming out. I don't know if you can see that, but black glove and black plastic, but see that stuff falling off of there? But if you also, you can see that it's just shredded. The rubber part that's like a star in here is just in little pieces. It never even got wet. So that's junk. We'll see if we can find a pump that works. So we fried that pump, little trip to Harbor Freight, and got a replacement. Question is, now I've got to change the alignment of this drill. So we'll get to it. The pump that I fried had zero directions with it. It was just literally the pump in a little white box when it came from Amazon. And I mean, I should have used some common sense, primed it, and I did not. And it essentially could not prime itself, and it wore itself out in about 30 seconds. So this one, from Harbor Freight, costs five times as much money, which is funny that the Harbor Freight pump is so much more, but it does come with some instructions and warnings, like don't try to run it dry like I did. So that alone puts us in a little better shape. Yeah, I'm gonna have to change the drill around. Yeah. So this one is labeled in and out, and it has the direction of rotation marked on it, which is nice. The other one had only an in out mark on it. I kind of think I might not have been running the pump, the drill, fast enough, and it just wasn't keeping up with losses from air getting in. So I'm gonna try again. I'm gonna prime it again, and I'm gonna run it right here with no exit hose so I can actually see what's going on. Got the hose fully primed. goes. Yeah, so it is working. Part of my problem, I'm sure, is I've only got 4 inches of liquid in the bottom of the can right now, and that hose wants to keep curling up, so it's not staying on the bottom. I'm probably sucking air in, which is my problem. So I'm gonna find something to weight that down, like a jack stand. Perfect, right after I prime it again.
You know, it occurs to me that a check valve would really come in handy on the feed end of the hose. I know that there's one that is sold as a gas tank siphon. I've seen a little video of it working where you just slam it down into the gas and it will fill the tube without backflowing out. That would be really handy here because it would keep the liquid from draining back out the hose. That's been the biggest problem, is once you stop this pump, any air pressure in the tire just pushed all the liquid back out. You had to completely reprime it.
I can feel that load on it. So I know it's pumping now.
I did this action right here 110 times throughout this process. I did not record all of it.
So I recounted my bottles. We had 57 bottles empty, and there's a gallon and a half to 2 gallons left in the bottom of the can. The can's bottom is not flat, so it's got difficulty sucking every last drop out of there. According to Messick's tire fill chart, these tires should take 55 gallons. So we hit our target on this tire. We're going to reinstall our valve stem and then pressurize the tire, and we'll finish the other half off camera. You guys don't need to watch that again. But that process, once we got the pump figured out, it actually ran really smooth. Things I learned about these kind of pumps, they got to run pretty fast. You've got to prime them, and you've got to prime the exit hose too, because once that liquid drains out, it's trying to push air back through the pump, and it's basically unpriming itself. As soon as you stop the pump, back pressure of air is going to push back through the pump, and anytime you stop, you've got to reprime the pump. Other than that, get a pump that works. This one didn't seem like it wanted to work at first, but it was because I wasn't getting it fully primed. The pump that I used before off Amazon for like $3 was a throwaway. It, granted, didn't get primed, but it burned itself up in less than 30 seconds of running. Pay attention to the direction everything should run. This one does want to run clockwise. I had that confused in my head for a second. Didn't blow the pump up, but figured that out. This tire is now ballasted. We'll get the other one done. We'll have this tractor out running. Hope you found that informative. I know I learned a couple things. And we'll catch you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the content. Thanks. Double check the manual. For this tire, Kubota wants 20 PSI.